if there is going to be the longest game in baseball history, it belongs in Pawtucket, Rhode Island. In the larger scheme of things, this is a meaningless game. Rochester scores in the seventh inning, 1-0. Pawtucket scores in the bottom of the ninth in a sacrifice fly. Okay, extra innings. Now it's the 15th inning, and it's after midnight. There's a curfew. For some reason, that single paragraph saying that no inning shall begin after 12:50 a.m. disappeared.
We continued to play, and play, and play, and play.
Once we got into like the 18th inning, it's war now.
There was a couple balls that were hit really good. I remember Sam Bowen hit one on a 3-0 pitch.
Left fielder goes back, looks up, we're hooping and hollering, and all of a sudden the wind blows it right back.
I says, if that ball didn't get out here, we're gonna be here all night.
In the 21st inning, Rochester scores, and now it's 2-1. It's the bottom of the 21st.
And I came up with a guy on second and two outs and hit a double to tie the game.
It's probably 2 a.m. now. She says, Joe, where are you? What are you doing, drinking beer all night? Believe me, there's still a game going on, and she hung up.
So the score is tied 2-2. They will resume this game the next time Rochester is in town.
We had reporters from Japan and all over the world.
Rochester doesn't score in the top of the 33rd, and then in the bottom of the 33rd, Dave Koza gets up to the plate, and he hits this looper over Cal Ripken's head. The Pawtucket Red Sox have won the longest game in baseball history. And the fact that a game could go into extra innings and that those innings could last forever is part of the charm and the distinction of baseball.